Simon, first of all, congratulations on a great season with Lancashire. The club must be absolutely buzzing at the moment after winning the second division title.
Thank you, yeah. Obviously, it was our goal at the start of the season to get back into Division 1, and thankfully we achieved it, and we played some really good cricket, and luckily we didn't take it down to the last game of the season as well, which hopefully going into next year we can be as strong as we were a couple of years ago.
And for you, 57 first-class wickets, happy with that?
Yeah, obviously it's an improvement on last season, so it's going in the right direction. Obviously it'll be a good test next year back in Division 1, hopefully can repeat what I've done this year.
I was with the Lancashire lads down at Bristol when they won the title against Gloucestershire, and it seemed a real conviction that they can go on and win the championship next year.
Definitely, we've got a more improved squad maybe from what we had when we won it previous year. Obviously you don't know whether Simon Kerrigan might come back or might not. Obviously he was amazing for us this year, but all our younger players, or from 3 years ago it would be now, have all got improved, and hopefully we'll be going into it next year stronger than we were a couple of years ago.
And today the signing of Josh Butler is not going to do your one day cricket any harm.
No, there's been a bit of rumour around for the past couple of weeks, and it's a great signing for us, and he'll fit right in.
Do you know Josh?
Yeah, I've been away with him like a couple of times on this EPP, and he's a good lad, and all the lads will warm to him pretty well.
What do you think he's going to bring to Lancashire squad?
I think obviously you see it on international stage, he's one day sort of finishing of the innings. I think that if there's anything that what we struggled in one day cricket is our sort of our finishing off games batting wise, and I think sort of his dynamic at the end, and I think that'll be what he'll add to us, and he's obviously a great striker, and he's sort of hopefully he'll be wanting to sort of get plenty of championship runs as well, which hopefully he can.
And of course he's coming to Lancashire to keep wicket, because that was the thing probably that's made him leave Somerset, and so he can have his wicket keeping skills, and he's working on his wicket keeping, improving all the time.
Yeah, definitely. Obviously there's Peter Moores, who's a former wicket keeper as well, and John Stanworth, who's the academy coach, who's also a wicket keeper, so as I say, that would have had a bit of a sway in him signing for Lancs.
Can't talk to you without mentioning your Test match appearance this year. Obviously things didn't go according to plan, but you took some pretty heavy flack after that, and I know I was talking to a Lancashire scorer and he said that he was really upset with some of the headlines. He was even going to write to a paper about them. How did you react when you saw the papers?
Obviously, like I was saying before to Wade, that people, like critics, are paid to be critical, and if you don't perform, you expect that you're going to get them headlines, but I think it's about not taking it too personally and sort of moving on from it and proving him wrong.
And do you feel you're perhaps a stronger person as a result of it?
I think I'm definitely better off for having the experience at 24 than I would be if I was 32 and making my debut. I've still got plenty to learn with my game, and I feel like I can come back stronger and sort of prove to everyone.
Now this a trip to Australia with the England performance squad, a chance to sample different conditions. Have you been to Australia before?
Yeah, we went last year for the Lions in a one-day tour. Obviously, it's red ball cricket this year, which is a different challenge, and the conditions are pretty flat, I think, generally for spin, so it'll be a good test.
And what will you be working on particularly, or what are you working on with your bowling at the moment?
It's just a continual work of trying to sort of know my action and get the consistency and sort of figuring out game plans for different scenarios, and it's just a continual sort of stride to try and keep getting there.
Do Australian pitches suit you, do you think?
Generally, you get a bit of bounce maybe, but generally they're quite flat, but I think like any pitch, and if you're playing 3 or 4 days on it, there's going to be a bit of wearing on it, and there'll be footholds to bowl in, so that won't change too much.
I suppose the obvious ambition is to make the most of these chances so that the Test match opportunity comes around again.
Definitely, I think that if I can keep progressing and keep learning, I feel like my game's more than good enough for Test cricket, so hopefully sort of keep building and working towards it.